you know about a switching network, like we have seen a crossbar switch, right? We saw that M cross N matrix, right? I hope you remember it. Like we were connecting the M input lines to the N output lines, right? Using the switches. So such networks are called as switching networks, right? Now what he is saying, switching network should have a greater number of outlets than the switches from which they are built, right? If I say a 4 cross 4 matrix, then in that case the number Sorry, there was a problem with the internet. Okay, I was talking about that M cross N matrix, if you remember, right? In that the total number of switches will be M into N, right? Now what he's saying, switching network should have greater number of outlets than the switches from which they are built. For example, if I say 4 cross 4, in that case the number of switches will be how many? 4 into 4, that is 16, right? Now what he's saying, the number of outlets should be greater than the number of switch, right? That means what? The number of switches should be lesser than the number of outgoing lines, right? I hope you're understanding. If I say 4 cross 4, we were able to build a 4 cross 4 matrix, or say switching network, by using how many switches? 4 into 4, that is 16. But what he's saying, it should not be 16, because 16 is greater than 4, because we have only 4 outgoing lines, right? If I say 4 cross 4, 4 input lines and 4 output lines are there. But for constructing that, how many switches you are using? 4 into 4, that is 16, which is greater, right? 16 is greater than 4. So that should not be the case, he is telling. What he's saying, the switches should be always less, right? It should be less than the number of outlets, right? That is what he's saying. So he's, look at this statement once again, like switching network should have a greater number of outlets than the switches from which they are built, right? That is how the network should be. Now how to achieve this, right? How can we achieve a more number of output lines by using lesser number of switches? So this can be achieved by connecting the switching stages in tandem, right? So what we do is we make use of switching networks which are connected in tandem. Tandem means they will be connected in a serial fashion. So we are talking about switching networks which will be connected in a serial fashion. Now one example he has given, example is that of a Strouger exchange, right? What he is saying, a Strouger exchange gives access up to 10,000 line terminations by using 3 ranks of 100 outlet selectors. Means what? Now if I want to achieve, now if I want to achieve 100 output network, or you can say I want to achieve a switching network that has got 10,000 output lines, right? So I want to come up with the switching network that has got 1,000 output lines, right? How can I achieve it? I can achieve it by making use of 100 outlet selectors, right? I will make use of only 100 outlet selectors, or say selectors that are having 100 output lines, right? And how many of them I am using? I am using 3. Means I am using 300 output selectors and I am connecting them in tandem, right? Which will give me what? Which will give me 10,000 output selector, right? I hope you are understanding. Now if I want to come up with a switching network with 10,000 line terminals. How can I build it? I can build it by connecting three 100 outlet selectors in a serial fashion, right? I have 300 outlet selectors, and if I connect them in tandem, I will be building a 10,000 line or outlet selector, right? First, let us talk about single stage network. Single stage means there is only one networking stage here, right? We are not connecting multiple stages, networking stages in tandem. It consists of only one stage, right? Only one network will be there. Only one stage of network, no multiple stages, right? Such networks are called as single stage networks. Now, this is the diagram. This diagram you already seen, right? This is a M cross N matrix, right? We have M inlets. I hope you guys are able to see the cursor. We have M inlets and N outlets. And how many switches are used for constructing this? It is obviously M into N, right? The total number of switches, used here are M into N, right? Now these may, for example, be a separate relays or electronic devices or contacts of a crossbar switch. Means what? In here, in the place of the switches, I can either use relays, right? Or I can use an electronic device or contacts of a crossbar switch, right? If I say contacts of a crossbar switch, I am talking about that mechanical one, right? Mechanical switching system where we were inserting the brass pegs, if you remember, right? Now I can use a brass peg, depends upon the technology. I can use a brass peg or I can use an electronic device, right? Or I can use a relay. Now this is a M cross N matrix, remember it. And how many switches are there? Number of total number of switches are M into N, right? Now the network could also be constructed by multiplying the banks of M uniselectors or one level of group of M two motion selectors, each having N outlets. Now you need to understand what is a motion selector. Motion selector means if I make use of a motion selector, one line can be connected to multiple lines, right? Remember this, if I say a motion selector, what will be the motion selector? Motion selector means one line will be capable of connecting to multiple output lines at a different time, right? Such entities are called as motion selectors, right? Now what is saying, the network could also be constructed, the same network can also be constructed by multiplying the banks of M uniselectors, right? Or one level of group of M two motion selectors, each having N outlets. Means what? Here in this diagram, we have how many inlets? M inlets I have, right? Suppose if I consider the first inlet, right? For the first inlet, I can go for a motion selector. How I can make this first line to get connected to all the output lines. How many output lines are there? N output lines are there, right? So what I will do, I will take the first line, right? And I will make use of a uniselector, right? I will make use of a uniselector, and arrangement will be such that this first input line will be capable of connecting to N output lines at different instants of time, right? That is what it is saying. See, by multiplying the banks of M uniselectors or one level of group of M two motion selectors, each having N outlets. You will understand it better when we proceed to the diagram of that uniselector, okay? Now, future systems means, of course, as I used to tell in the theory class, this textbook is related to the old, line wired telephonic system. right? This textbook basically explains about wired telephonic system. As I used to tell in the class, what is saying? Future systems may make use of photonic switches. Photonic switches are nothing but they are switches that work with the what you can say, optical signal directly, right? Getting it? Now whatever switching we saw till now, the switching action was happening because of electrical signal, not because of optical signal, right? So what he's saying, in future what will happen, he's saying that they may start using photonic switches. Photonic switches are nothing but the switches that will make use of optical signal directly. There will be no electrical signal involved, right? Of course, he is talking about future, but we have already reached the stage, right? So now in the present telephone communication system, they are already using photonic switches. He is saying what will happen in a photonic switch there. In a photonic switches, what will happen? There will be they will consist of optoelectronic devices. Optoelectronic devices means what? They are capable of converting optical signal to electrical signal, and also electrical signal to optical signal whenever required, right? So if you make use of photonic switches, what will happen? Now whatever switches you are seeing here, these switches will be replaced by photonic switches, right? They will be used as a cross point to make connections between optical fiber trunks, right? And it is obvious, right? Like if you want to make use of optical fiber, the signal should be in optical form only. I cannot transfer our electrical signal in optical fiber, right? Even though the signal is in electrical form, I need to convert it into optical form before transmitting, right? So that job will be done by these photonic switches. Now the same network, the same network that you are seeing here, this same M cross N matrix that you are seeing, the same matrix can be represented in simplest form, simplified form. How I can draw it? The same network, I can draw it in this fashion, right? Or I can write it in this fashion also. Now if you observe here, it simply consists of a square box, right? And one vertical line and one horizontal line which are intersecting. And we have this circle here. I will tell you the significance of this circle later. Similarly, I can draw the same network in this fashion. Now these two are simple representation of a M cross N switch, right? Now if you are using a figure for representing electromechanical switches, electromechanical switches, I hope you remember it. Like we used to insert a brass peg, right? A crossbar switch, hope you remember it. There we used to insert what? A brass peg for every connection. So such systems are called as electromechanical switches. Now if you are using the figure for representing electromechanical switches, now in that case, what this circle indicates, like this is a circle, this tiny circle. This circle indicates what? It indicates the side of the switch associated with control mechanism. Or if I say that crossbar switch, this particular circle indicates what? The brass peg, right? You are inserting a brass peg, right? So this circle indicates that you are inserting a brass peg in the case of crossbar switch. Similarly, if you are using an electromechanical switch, the circle indicates side of a switch which is associated with control mechanism. Now control mechanism may be a wiper of a Strausser switch. I hope you remember Strausser switch that we discussed in the class, right? It may represent wiper of a Strausser switch or a bridge magnet of crossbar switch, this circle, right? So these two are simple form of representing a M cross N switching network. You can either represent it like this diagram or this diagram. Now the matrix of cross point what is saying, the matrix of the cross point gives full availability. Now what is full availability? Full availability means, let us go back to the previous diagram, right? In the previous diagram, what was there? Let me go back to the diagram. Now this diagram, in this diagram, what is happening, if you observe, every input line is connected to every output line, right? There is a provision for connecting every input line to every output line. I hope you're understanding. I repeat once again, in this matrix, there is a provision for connecting every input line to every output line, or you can say that they are already connected, right? See, every input line can be connected to every output line. If such is the condition, we say the switching system has got full availability, right? So if I ask you, what is full availability? Full availability happens only if every input line is connected to every output line, right? Or you can say it should have a provision of connecting every input line to every output line. If that is the case, we say that there is a full availability, right? Now in this diagram, you can observe we have full availability. See what you're saying now, the matrix of cross points gives full availability. And if there is a network with full availability, one more thing will happen. What is that? No calls will be lost unless all outgoing trunks are congested, right? So there will be no loss of calls until and unless what? Outgoing trunks are congested. Means what? Until and unless all the outgoing trunks are busy, no calls will be lost. In which case? In the case of full availability. What is full availability? Full availability is nothing but, in a switching network, if every input line is connected to every output line, we say it has got a full availability. Now here, the number of simultaneous connections that can be made is either m or n, right? The number of simultaneous connections that can be made is either m if m is less than n, or it will be n if n is less than m. Just a second. Right, the number of simultaneous connections that can be made is either m or n. Now this is obvious. The switch contains how many cross points? M into n, right? Since we have m inputs and n outputs, the switch will contain m into n cross points, right? Now if m is equal to n, as in the case of the diagram that we saw earlier, right? There, if you observe the diagram carefully, how many lines were there? Like 4 lines. Of course, it is represented as m, but in the diagram it is 4 lines, right? So m was equal to n in the diagram that we saw. Number of input lines was equal to number of output lines. So we can say m is equal to n. If m is equal to n, the number of cross points will be how much? Cross points are nothing but switches, right? They are the number of switches that will be used. Now the number of cross points is nothing but C1 equal to n square. Why? Because here m is equal to n, right? Right? A switch will contain m into n. If m is equal to n, I can write it as n square, right? So the number of cross points will be C1 equal to n square. Thus, what he's saying, the cost increases as the square of the size of the switch. if n square, this value, the n square value, if this value goes on increasing, the cost will increase. Or indirectly is trying to tell that in a switching network, if there are more number of switches, obviously the cross of that switching network will be high, right? So the cost of the switching network depends upon how many switches you are using, right? If you are using huge number of switches, obviously the cost of that switching network will be very high. Now, if I ask you how to reduce the cost of the switching network, right? To reduce the cost of the switching network, what I should do? I should reduce the number of switches, right? Now, if I reduce the number of switches, what will happen? Will I get full availability? No, I won't get full availability. If I reduce the number of switches, obviously every input line will not be connected to every output line, and hence there will not be full availability, right? That those things we'll see later. Okay. Now, one more thing is there. It is called as efficiency. Now, efficiency, how do you define efficiency for a given switching network? For a given switching network, efficiency is given by 1 by n, right? Efficiency is given by 1 by n. What is n? N is the number of switches, or say the number of cross points, right? Now, if n increases, if the number of switches increase, obviously what will happen to the efficiency? Efficiency will decrease, right? Or you can say efficiency, that is given by 1 by n, decreases inversely with n. If n increases, efficiency will decrease. So what is saying, it is therefore uneconomic to use a single stage network for large number of inputs, inlets and outlets. Now, if the network has got very huge number of input lines and very huge number of output lines, obviously the n value will be high, right? If n value is high, what will happen to the efficiency? Efficiency will decrease. At the same time, what is happening to the cost? Cost will increase, right? That is why he's saying it will be therefore uneconomic to use a single stage network for large number of inlets and outlets. So what they do, even suppose the situation needs more number of inlets and more number of outlets, in that case what they will do is they will not go for single stage network. Instead of that, they will use multi-stage network. Why they go for multi-stage network? One reason is cost will be reduced, right? One more reason is efficiency will not be affected, or say efficiency will not be decreased, right? So if the, again recalling once again, if the number of input lines and the number of output lines are huge, we won't go for single stage switching network because the cost will increase, at the same time efficiency will decrease. So what they will do, they will go for multi-stage networks. What is a multi-stage network again? Connecting single stage networks in tandem is called as multi-stage network. Now, one example he has taken, what will happen if the number of inlets and outlets are huge, right? So the example is saying that, assume that a switching network has got 100 inputs, 100 inlets, right? A switch with he's saying that we have a necessity that a switching network should have 100 inlets and 100 outlets, right? If I go for 100 inlets and 100 outlets, obviously how many cross points should be there? It will be 100 into 100. Right, 100 into 100 is nothing but 10,000 cross points. So here 10,000 cross points are required, right? 10,000 is nothing but n square here, right? Getting it? 10,000 is nothing but n square, because you saw like C1, what was C1? N square. That is nothing but number of cross points. C1 equal to n square. So n square is nothing but what is n square is nothing but what? 10,000 yen, right? How we got n square? How we got this 10,000? Because n into n. How much is n? 100, right? So if n is 100, what will happen to the efficiency now? Efficiency is given by 1 by n. So that will be 1 divided by 100, or it will be only 1%, right? Efficiency will be 1%, or you can say, what does it mean? If I say that efficiency is 1%, what does it mean? It means that I can use only 1% of the cross points at a given time, right? Getting it? Or you can say, I can use that switching network only 1% in a given time, right? Even though it has got 100 inlets and 100 outlets and 10,000 cross points, how much percentage we are using? Only 1% at a given time, and hence efficiency is very less here, right? So it becomes costlier. Even if I go for such network, the cost will be increased, right? Because the number of cross points are more. So what they will do? Now what they can do now? They will go for multi-stage network. That we'll see later. Okay. Switches for making connections between large number of trunks are therefore constructed as networks containing several stages of switches. This is what I was talking about. Instead of going for single stage, now they go for multiple stages of networks. We'll see that figure 3.1 later. Okay. As of now, let us go through this statement. What is saying? Let us go through the diagram only, like figure 3.1. Where was that? Now this is the figure 3.1. Remember this, okay? Now what is saying in the figure 3.1? If the switch shown in the figure 3.1 is used to make connections between n similar circuits, then each circuit is connected to both inlet and outlet. Right. Each circuit is connected to both inlet and outlet. Circuit is nothing but a switch. That means each switch is connected to both the input line as well as output line in the initial diagram in figure 3.1. Now, operation of a cross point at coordinates j comma k to connect inlet j to outlet k thus performs the same function as operating cross point k comma j to connect the inlet k to outlet j. To understand this, let us go back to the diagram. Okay, I will go back to the diagram 3.1. There you will understand. So consider any one coordinate here, right? If I consider this as j comma k, this coordinate as j comma k, means what? It is connecting the first vertical line with the second horizontal line. So let us consider this as j comma k, right? This is nothing but one comma two. If I say it is 1, 2, because it is connecting first vertical line and second horizontal line. Similarly, if I consider 2, 1, right? 2, 1 means this is 2, right? This will be 1. Again, this is a different thing, like this is connecting. Just a second. Give me some time. See what is saying? The operation of the cross point at coordinates j comma k. J comma k, you take one example like 1, 2,
right? If I consider 1, 2 here, what it will be connecting? It will be connecting inlet 1 to outlet 2, right? He, what he's saying, if I say 1, 2, it will perform the same function as operating cross point 2, 1, right? To connect inlet 2 to outlet 1, right? Or he's trying to say that like the number of switches used there are more. Actually, we don't need such more number of switches there. How many switches were there in that network? If you consider 4x4 matrix, how many switches were there? Will be there like 4 × 4? That is 16, right? 16 switches are there. But according to him, what he's saying is 16 switches are not needed actually, because most of the switches there, half of the switches are doing the redundant job. Means what? They are, the repetition of job is happening there. Getting it? So what he's trying to say is, in a given network, say for example 4x4 network, there need not be 16 switches, he's telling. I can reduce the number of switches. Let us see how he has reduced it. See, this is what he's saying. Consequently, half of the cross points are redundant. Means what? We can nullify half of the switches. In the example that we took 4x4 matrix, right? 4x4 means how many switches were there? 16 switches were there. He's saying that out of those 16 switches, 8 switches will be redundant. 8 switches are redundant. Means what? They are dummy, or you can say they are extra. 8 switches are extra and they can be eliminated. Right? Let us see how he has achieved it. He is saying that half of the switches that we use are redundant, or say they are not needed actually. Right? They are extra. So he is going to eliminate them. How is he going to eliminate them? Let us see. Now he is saying that whatever matrix we saw, that is 4x4 matrix in the figure 3.11, right? Was it 3.1? Yes, 3.11. That will be changed to something called as triangular cross point matrix. We will see that. Let us go check that. I hope the PPT is visible to you, right? Now what I was telling, if I consider a 4x4 matrix, switching matrix, in that how many switches will be there? 16 switches will be there, right? Now what I'm saying, half of the switches will be redundant. That means out of 16, 8 switches are redundant and they can be eliminated, is saying, right? Let us see how he has done it. Okay, after removing half of the cross points, we will get something called as a triangular cross point matrix. Let us see that triangular cross point matrix. See, you will get a structure like this. This is the triangular cross point matrix, right? Triangular cross point matrix, right? Now here, if you observe, how many output lines are there? 4 output lines are there, right? How many input lines are there? These are the input lines. 1, 2, 3, 4. Sorry, how many are there? Yeah, it is, he has considered 5x5. Let it be. He has considered 5x5. So how many input lines? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many output lines? 5 output lines. Now if you observe here, what has happened is, here we don't have direct connection from every input line to every output line, right? We don't have a provision for connecting every input line to every output line directly here, right? Or what you can say, there is no full availability, right? But we can provide the connection anyhow if we feel. See here. Yeah, suppose assume that I want to connect line number 5, input line number 5, right? Line number 5 to line number output line number 5. Input 5 to output 5. Can I do it? Yes, I can do it, right? But the thing is, I need to close more than one switch. I hope you guys are understanding. I can connect the 5th input line to the 5th output line here also, provided that I should be closing, or say I should be making use of more than one switch at a time. I hope you're understanding, right?
So such in such cases we say that there is no full availability, right? Let us go back. So what he said, if I remove half of the cross points, it gives rise to something called as triangular cross matrix that you saw already, right? There obviously the number of cross points will be reduced, right? So the number of cross points required will be how much? Now this time C1 is given by half of n into n minus 1. Early in the earlier case, what was the formula for C1? C1 was simply n square. This time what has happened? The number of cross points formula is half of n into n minus 1, right? We have reduced the number of switches because half the switches are redundant, right? What is saying? Triangular switches are not usually found in telephonic switching systems because both way trunks are not used, right? Here what is saying, in triangular switches, trunks are operated only in one way, right? Means what? If person A wants to call person B, there will be a separate line, right? Similarly, if person A wants to call person B wants to call person A, then in that case again a different line will be used. Getting it? Both way communication is not possible here, right? Both way, or I can say full duplex communication is not possible through a single line here if I make use of triangular switches, right? The trunks are operated only on one way basis. Every trunk will be one way, right? For example, ringing tone and ringing current are sent over a separate one-way trunk depending upon whether a customer's line is calling or being called, right? Every trunk will do only one operation here, right? One-way operation if I make use of triangular switches. Now don't get confused here. When I say one-way, it doesn't mean that only one person can speak. No. Both will be speaking, getting it? Both will be speaking, but which line is used depends upon who is calling to whom, right? Getting it? There will be a separate line. There will be a separate line if person A is calling to person B. Similarly, there will be a separate line if person B is calling to person A. Two different lines at two different times based on the condition, whether it is a called person or calling person. Right? Don't get confused with the half duplex and full duplex. That it is a full duplex communication only. No question about that. It is a full duplex communication. The thing is that for every one way means depends upon whether person is calling somebody or he's been called by someone. Right? Okay, we will talk about grading in the tomorrow's class.